Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Fall of the Republic. So, I've been doing a bit of management of things, and I've made a couple of discoveries. First, these. I had been selling off the random leftovers that, you know, we had built, and then the front line moved. We still had one at Shazwa. So I've been selling those, and this whole time I was thinking that these things had a credit upkeep cost. But apparently they don't? I don't know if this was changed, or it just was never a thing. I'm fairly sure they have, or had, at one point, an upkeep cost. I don't know, but apparently they don't. Like, it doesn't say anywhere on the tooltip there, and there's nothing. So, I don't know. Obviously I'm mistaken, but I don't know, like, why. I must have been thinking of something else, or maybe they changed it. Maybe it has an upkeep in future versions? I have no idea. Another thing I noticed is this, which is actually sitting over a hypervelocity gun. That used to be actually more of a real fleet. Now it's just down to that. I'm not actually sure if this will actually shoot this down. I seem to remember there being some limitations. Like, I don't think they shoot down SSDs. And they're not meant to shoot down heroes. Although I don't know. Like, again, this is an older version. Either way, I left the gun there. We'll see. I have no interest in going over there and doing anything about it. It's not like we're not really losing influence, so it's not really a big deal. If it does get to be a big deal, then we'll deal with it. But I feel like the influence drop from blockading fleets isn't working in this version, or at least something about it doesn't quite work in this version. There was that time we had that fleet over Alderaan for many episodes, and it did nothing was really happening. I do think the influence was dropping slightly, but I think the main issue with it is that just the numbers are not quite balanced in this version, so we were losing like one point of influence every however long. I don't think we ever even got to 5 influence. So that suggests to me that just the amount of influence you lose over time is not correctly adjusted in this version. Not necessarily that it actually doesn't work, but whatever. It's not really a big deal. But I did also notice this. They moved one back. Now, it's possible that they've got stuff floating back and forth. But I think we should go for it. If nothing else, I want to actually be able to get these guys up over here. I feel like there was something else, but I don't remember. There is this. And I do think we should do that. It'll be tough. But it's not actually that bad, I think. Theoretically. I think the main problem with this is going to be that depending on the order in which they bring stuff in, like if they hit us with the battleships first, right? Then we will probably end up with, you know, at the very least, a mostly dead Praetor, an injured rest of the fleet, and then the rest of that stuff will start coming in, and the battle carriers, the actual ship isn't a problem, but four of them, that's a lot of strike craft that they will just have. And if we're destroying the Lucre Hulks, the actual carriers, like, that could get nasty. On the other hand, if they start off with the carriers, and because of the way that the AI, like, the way that it selects the fleet when everything spawns on the map to start with, the way it basically works is that it tries to get as many different unit types onto the field as possible, and because the battle carriers don't take up as much popcap as the battleships, that's why usually they have the battle carriers out first when they have other ships with them. So, because basically you can have a battle carrier and more other things than you can have a battleship and more other things. So if that is the case, what we'd probably want to end up doing is leaving the Lucre Hulk alone until we destroy all of the lesser ships as much as possible. Because if we destroy the battle carriers as they come in, what will end up happening is like two carriers in, we will be just being swarmed with fighters, and if we want to deal with the strike craft, it'll harm our ability to deal with the battleships. So, what kind of fleet do we really need for that? Is the big question. Other than that, I think we want to do this. I'm actually going to do... Can you... Yes. Wait. You don't have bombing runs, do you? Do you? Yes. Oh?
Tactical battle imminent.
Ah. Okay. Doesn't look like they brought any more back, so we should just have the one. Other than this, Dantooine and Debrillion, I actually want to send Dodonna and Vader down to Utapau to deal with that. This is going to be a thing.
Moving out.
Course
plotted.
Preparing for hyperspace jump.
Did they not have an ion cannon here?
Ion cannon firing.
Well, I guess that answers that question.
Your favorite Hulta respond.
Starting my run. Setting up my run, sir.
Making
permission to jump to light speed.
Right, sir. Maximum unit capacity. Yes.
Oh no. Yes, sir. Target acquired.
Charging generator. What's the order? Right, sir. Destroyer ready.
Reporting in.
Anyone need repairs? We can do that.
Yes, come on.
Hmm.
Go ahead, sir. Yeah, starting my run.
Star Destroyer standing by. Roger that.
I've lost count. How many does that make?
Awaiting orders.
Why can you not just pull forward? What is you people's issues?
Awaiting your orders.
You got the captain.
Okay.
I copy.
Copy that.
You guys want to actually, like, engage the bombers, maybe? Oh, this thing should not have come in at this sort of angle. Actually, it shouldn't have come in at all. What is it doing? It was well in range over here. Don't get too close. Alright, now, we need to try and get...
Air cruiser, standing by.
Transmit orders. Signal coming through. Cruiser here. Radio. We want to try and keep it on that side of the nebula while our stuff kind of gets into range.
Star Destroyer standing by.
So, somehow. Why are you trying to move? Just turn and fire. Not a lot of bombers. Interesting. Are you in range? Not really. I thought these things had longer range than... actually, I shouldn't say that. I kind of assumed that they had longer range. I don't actually know. And... I don't think there's any way I can actually easily find out, is there?
Destroyer reporting.
Reinforcements back around for another
run. Our target priority is the laser cannon.
Getting a lock.
Holding fire for maximum effect.
Excellent shot. They won't know what hit them.
No, it's wanting to get way up in there. That's not good.
Radio channels
open. What are you doing?
Go ahead, sir.
Locking on. Intercepting.
You've got a clear shot.
Enemies in range.
Like, even with just the slight incidental fire from this thing is already half down on shields. That's just ridiculous. These things... they're just scary.
Watch your tail. You picked up a try.
Thanks for the warm welcome, Commander.
Charging generator.
She's doing fine, though, and this thing's shields are down, so we're not really in any real danger. Although, getting through this gap is going to be a pain, I suspect. Although I suppose we could just send these guys into here and then send them through. That's okay.
Star Destroyer reporting in.
Can you get in here?
Destroyer ready. Enemy re-vectoring now.
Appeared on long
Okay, no, you're too close.
Radio channels open.
Primary engine system is down.
Carillion gunship on station.
Hold the frigate here.
Cruiser here. Heading
to. Are we seriously going to lose this thing to the Golem? Get in there.
Transmit orders.
Our launch bay has been disabled.
Yeah, we are. Wow. Okay. That's frustrating.
Give me a target.
Yes, Commander.
According to the numbers, these things are like they are squishier than the leveler acclimators. But by the numbers, they're not that much squishier. But, like, when they actually get into combat, they just fall apart. So much quicker than the levelers. At least, it feels like it. Maybe it's just, you know, different situations, and it kind of feels similar, and it actually isn't, but it, I don't know.
Those torpedo launchers must be destroyed.
Destroy our holding. We'll level them.
Now that's how we do it.
Like, the shields are a fair bit weaker. Like, hang on. Do we have a leveler. 2000. 1800. And 2300 hull versus 2800. Like, that's, you know, significant. But it feels like as soon as these things lose shields, like, half of their hard points are just ripped off almost immediately. I don't know. I wonder if there's something off about them in this version. Because, like, even these feel sturdier to me. And they don't, like...
There's nothing we can't handle.
The stats are not that far off. And these guys just feel a little more survivable. I don't know. That's not what I want. No, that is what I want. I thought I hit retreat for us. That's weird. Oh! It was the ground units. Oh well, what's two units? Big deal. Yeah, I don't know. It's just... Something about those Acclimator 2s feels just... off to me for some reason. I don't know what it is. And it's entirely possible that it's just pure, like, anecdotal, you know, it's just purely because, are you serious? Whatever. But yeah, just finish that thought. It's entirely possible that it's just plain... whatever you call it, anecdotal, you know, just seems that way, but isn't really. But I don't know.
Tactical battle imminent.
This planet, I highly suspect, will not have an ion cannon because it is sat back here in the back of the galaxy, like at the farthest north, and it wasn't anywhere near anything of ours for most of this campaign. I would be very surprised if there was and I'm surprised. And they're firing at the the Praetor. Okay, well, never mind. I guess. But I don't, why would there be an ion cannon here?
Cruising speed.
Clear path.
Get orders.
One shot, one kill. We're gaining on them.
Yes, charging generator.
Missile tubes loaded.
Got you on the comm. There's nothing we can't handle.
Well, I have fighter support.
Destroyer here.
Transmit orders.
Full throttle.
Pelta frigate standing by. Pelta frigate
destroyer
moving in.
Ready.
There's not really any point in trying to move in any kind of formation, is there? What is this? No. Just go straight. Is this?
Fixing course.
Yeah.
Proton bombs in the chute.
It's that whatever is going on with the not collision, the pathfinding, whatever it is. I haven't noticed it with the Dreadnought shipyards, and it's doing it with the heavy frigate shipyards. I wonder if it's just those, or if the light frigate factories or shipyards do the same thing. I haven't really paid attention to what kind of... Well, not so much what kind, but I don't tend to distinguish between these and the light ones very much, because they're not that different. Haven't really paid a whole lot of attention when we're getting this weird issue. Yeah, it's definitely... like offsetting the
reinforcements have arrived.
Pathfinding interference and it's like in the center of the map when it should be over there. You know what it might be, actually? I just had a thought. Maybe it has nothing to do with how tanky or squishy the actual vessel is. Maybe it has everything to do with the AI's targeting priorities. Because these things are just little carriers, and they don't tend to shoot at them much, I feel. So maybe the problem is not so much, oh, these, there's something wrong with these, and they're actually squishier than they're supposed to be. Maybe it's just they take fire much more quickly and much more noticeably than these do. That would definitely explain it.
They're in our sights. Let's blow something up.
Reporter.
Hmm.
Your orders, General.
You got him.
Ready for orders, Commander. Rockets away.
Destroyer ready.
Shields are cutting power.
That may be slow.
All your squad mates are being destroyed.
Clearing the skies.
Cause like we had several other ships that came in range before this thing did, and that Golan was immediately targeting that.
Cannons charged. Missile tubes loaded.
Focusing all
like,
targeting computer
access. As soon as it came into range, it was under fire. So I guess maybe it's a combination of it is fairly squishy, like these ones, but they like to target it more so than bees. Interesting. I bet that's exactly the problem. Are we missing a Venator? Did I only put two now? Really? More enemy craft. Am I confused? I might be confused. Make sure you destroy the Gazantes. But yeah, now that I really think about it, that does seem fairly likely that it would be just targeting priorities rather than the actual numbers for the hull and shields. And that does also, if that is the case, that does make a pretty good argument for using more of these rather than the twos. Well, before we get anything else shot down, let's go ahead.
Invasion commencing.
Take Bimisari. Okay, just random beeping like it was a
beginning construction.
A detonator or something. That was kind of weird. Huh. Well, for sure, Delta Squad, because they haven't seen any action in... I don't even know. How long has it been? Many episodes, for sure. They had... What did they have? I don't remember. It's been a while since we actually probed this. Oh, hi. Just wanna roll up and get yourself blown up? By chance? I guess they don't really roll. You guys go that way. Just real quick, which one of these is none of these? Okay. That thing is just dead. Oh, you didn't both use... Oh, well, that was a waste of a detonator.
Our base is under attack.
If you could just not do whatever it is you're doing. Is this not a capturable one? Oh, well.
Took a while.
Stay together.
Belay that order. Lock and load, Deltas.
Together. That's a good part. Not bad.
I suppose the capturable ones don't show up, like, in the fog of war. Like, these walls show up even in the fog of war, but the buildings don't, and the capturable buildings don't either. So, guess I should have realized that. Oh my goodness gracious. Hi! Two... Three... Four... Five? Yep. Right. Okay then. Yeah, you're gonna have to go, I'm afraid, because I really don't want to fight that many of those things with a command bonus. That doesn't sound fun at all. I would say we could use this, but they just tend to walk up and get themselves shot. I'll try it again. I assume that I'm just using them wrong in some way. Hey, if you want to come say hi to Delta, that'd be cool. What are you doing? Yep, there goes that. That should be theoretically helpful. Where is... There is,
Watch those wrist rockets! I've got you! I'm your reinforcement.
Let's do this.
Move it! They might actually be able to do that.
Hold. Not quite yet.
Oh, can you just straight up take one of those things? They totally can. I mean, I know it's just one, but still. Oh. Ugh. Hello. Are you sure you want to stand right there? I mean, seems like a bad idea. But who am I to argue? We missed one. Try and break that first, please. If you could possibly come over here. That's not what I want. Yeah, if there was a planet to use that sort of thing, of course we got most of them in the bombing round, so. Eh, still.
Reinforcements en route.
That's a question. What among all of this would be best against buildings? I suspect the mass driver, probably, but let's try these. I totally forgot to move this up. Okay, well. Okay, you're shooting all of the less useful targets. That's cool. Didn't actually tell them to attack it.
Ready to engage.
What was that?
Oh, you're stuck, aren't you? Yep. Guess they don't really have anything else, do they? No. Oh. Hello? Did they call it off?
Did you hear something? Are you trying to baffle the enemy into submission, sir?
And the Lardy doesn't want to land here because reasons.
I think we got him.
Yeah. Oh well.
Autogun ready to go. Going in.
You want to actually retreat this time? Huh.
Building
started. Alrighty.
Building under construction.
So there's that, and these guys can now move through here. Coburn, immediately go take command of that. You guys,
awaiting your order, sir.
Reinforce them. Probably don't actually need it, but whatever. Then, again, before we get something shot down, ooh, talk about something that needs reinforcements. Okay, this might be not great. Oh no, it's this map. Right. This is... This is the map that we lost an awful lot of stuff on last time. The only clones we've got are phase ones. Yikes. That's not great. Oh, and they've got a gajillion of those things. That's... Infantry pullback. I think these are probably the best thing to use against them. Good shot. Yeah, you're done. Back. We have no ability to build anything. That's not good. If we can save the enforcer, that'd be really nice. Oof. You're not hot, doing too hot either. Are you actually firing at that? It's like every other shot doesn't hardly do anything. Okay. Make a break for the doohickey. You two just don't. Don't think they have a whole lot left. It's been a while since we've actually seen commandos, interestingly. Wait, where did the droidica come from? Those things come in companies of like... What, 10? Something like that? We haven't... I just completely missed them. Suppose it's possible. Very least, they don't have the base shield this time, because that was just awful.
Order acknowledged.
Yep, they're out. vastly better than the last time we were here.
Construction complete.
And then straight back into it.
Invasion commencing.
Oh dear, I know this map. Oh, I should have been on the other side. Oh, well, whatever.
Defensive positions! Defensive positions! Ready when you are.
Construction complete. At maximum unit capacity.
Better turn fast! Loners don't survive long! We're taking the hostile! Yes!
Come on now. Is this a bad idea? I feel like this might be a bad idea.
All right. We done here? Moving. Oh, there you are. Someone get me some lunch.
Auto guns online. Going in.
The fact that there's a building right there is maybe gonna make this questionable. Can you guys really not handle one little stab? No thanks. Oh, really? Things were just getting interesting. I wonder what the other building is they have.
System conquered.
Well, that'll certainly do that.
Constructing.
I definitely should have done that far earlier. So that they would never have a chance to come out and hit Dantooine like that. Could have saved us some trouble. Oh. You didn't actually get sent.
Move forward.
Construction complete.
What have we got here? Okie dokie. It's definitely not a doom stack. Not by any means. I thought they really had more back here. For some reason, I thought they had two subjugators. Obviously not, but I'm certain we didn't destroy one, so either I'm misremembering or they managed to get one off at some point. Yeah, it's entirely possible they managed to get one off. This whole area was a mess there for quite a while. So it's entirely possible there was a gap at one point. Honestly, I think the ground is going to be the tougher thing to take than the space. Especially if they remain split up like this. Oh, good grief. Interestingly, they don't actually have that much ground production. So theoretically, if we can box them in and actually besiege them, then there's a good chance that they're only actually going to be able to get off one good ground assault. And if they hit, certainly if they hit Mon Calamari, we're going to destroy almost everything they've got. But even if they hit one of these two, could lock them in like they've Well, like we've got them on Sullust. I'm still just baffled that this planet has stayed here. I don't understand why they've never attacked it. Like we've never even had to repel an attack. They've just left it alone. Very odd. Weak turnover and that thing isn't shot down. I don't know if it's guaranteed every weak turnover to shoot something down. Or how that works. Influence hasn't gone down, so I don't really care, though. You know, it's interesting. Usually they will pull stuff back. Typically the entire fleet, but at the very least, most of the fleet, and they don't seem to have done that here. I don't know why. But this is a subjugator, and I don't know that this is gonna work. Well, let's give them a poke.
Safety check complete. Tactical battle imminent.
On the bright side, they don't have an ion cannon. On the less bright side, they sort of have an ion cannon.
Choose your reinforcements.
So the question is, if the Praetor takes the brunt of the assault, I think what we want to do is just dismantle this thing as fast as we can. So the question becomes, can we dismantle a subjugator before the subjugator dismantles us? I don't know the answer to that question. We're going to find out. You know, this might actually be... Oh, but I don't know. In the recent versions, or it's not actually even out yet. The fighter chain, fighter bomber reworks, and the anti-fighter reworks with the point defense stuff. Did they make it then to where things like assault concussion missiles do more damage, or are they just like that now? Oh, I don't know the answer to that question either. Let's go with these guys. And
Frigate on the move.
I copy that.
Entering hyperspace now.
At maximum unit capacity.
Oh boy. Okay. Well, I think this is a really bad idea. I'm just gonna put this out here. This is a bad idea. Almost certainly.
Emergency frequency open. Move it, driver.
We actually don't have an insubstantial number of bombers, but this thing is awfully close to that thing.
Hmm.
John Dodonna, sir.
Pelta here.
You are just going to hold position until something's shields go down.
That other ship over there.
Where did the... You know what?
This is Bravo 4.
I'm going to break the bombers off.
Shouldn't be long now.
And we're gonna head in.
Enemy units approaching.
Going to at the very least try.
I think
we will lose more by not trying that than go for the ion pulse cannon. Oh boy, as soon as it fires that thing. Oh, but we're doing a number to the shields. Pull off in this direction.
Without hesitation. Your orders, General.
Walmart.
Stay in formation.
Okie dokie.
Target at maximum range. Firing barrage.
She's turning. Concentrate on the one on the starboard side.
We've lost you on the sensors. We'll hold this position until you return.
Let's just do a bit of this. I'm not sure if a full squadron, a double squadron, can definitely take a single hardpoint. I don't know if just one can, though. I guess it doesn't matter terribly at this point. The shields are down. You just kind of scoot in over here. Her shields are still up. She's been stunned, but her shields are still up. And yeah, they're both gone. So
engaging with maximum power to shields. Our target priority is the laser.
Try not to target the ones that we've already targeted with the bombers. And with that, here we go. Okay, some of you bombed and some of you didn't. What gives? Can you reach that thing? That thing actually has a lot of heavy firepower in a little package.
Take out the iron cannons.
Take the shot now.
I'm here. I'll handle that.
Focusing all fire, General.
Waiting orders.
We're losing ground.
Try to concentrate on the ion cannons. It's got a lot of ion damage for something its size, certainly in this era.
Coming around.
That'll work. Okay, you are just whatever. How big is this? This is 98? 82. Okay, so either one of them goes down and they can bring in...
Where'd he go?
Oh. They had two there. You. Okay.
We're all set here, Commander.
You pull back. All forces commence ignoring the subjugator, or what's left of the subjugator. Because they still got one of these in reserve, and if at all possible, I'd like to not deal with it until this is mostly broken. You guys, you know what, just just fire. They're not going to listen to me anyway. Oh, we lost. Really? Oh. Okay, who's still firing missiles at the subjugator? What part of not the subjugator? Whose? Get the engines. It won't be able to move and maneuver as easily. You. Well, there goes that. Well, this is almost dead anyway, so. Next. There you are. Oh, this is inconvenient. No, not the fighters. Whatever you do, don't shoot at the fighters. That thing is a non-issue. Oh, run away. Actually, you know what? You probably... in a safe location? No, you're not. No, you're not. Never mind. Run away. Fire all the missiles. All the missiles. Run!
Go after the stragglers.
Yeah, we're good. Okay, so that's definitely a good way to handle the subjugators. Let the Praetor take the first hit, and then hit it as hard as possible, but it does require a lot of firepower to make that work. For some reason, every time we go up against a subjugator, they shoot these. I don't know why. Also, every time we go up against a subjugator, I forget that they shoot those, and end up having them in a location that ends up letting them get shot.
Where are we headed? Move forward. Tactical battle imminent. Hostiles in the area.
Charging generator. Destroyer ready.
Choose your reinforcements.
Orders confirmed.
Awaiting new directives.
As you command.
Ion cannon firing.
Oh. Woo-hoo! Oh, dang it.
General Dodona moving out.
Computer online.
Whoops. He was in a not good spot for that, because...
Understood.
Making the jump to light. Praetor is quite large. Oh, gosh, what? Oh, man. Oh, you're... Ouch. Well, I guess that's not gonna be a problem. That's not... great. Alrighty, let's roll in. That's an odd choice, but okay.
This is General Dodona. The mission is clear.
Arquinton's here.
We're outnumbered!
Arquinton's responding.
Yes, General.
Oh, did we not get a fleet tender? Oh, no, we did.
Stay in formation. We got you covered.
Taking fire.
Missile destroyer reporting in. All stations ready. Ready to update orders.
One thing you don't want is to get overwhelmed, or, well, not really overwhelmed, they don't have enough of that, but we don't want to lose shields before hitting that battleship, if at all possible. Was that a captor getting out? Or I guess it's the Auxilia that has that. Yeah, I just heard one. Oh no! You know what that is? That's these guys. Huh. Oh, the Kolovex has that too. Interesting. Whose engines? Oh, well. Missile destroyer here. You're not going to be super useful now.
Initiating combat protocols.
Awaiting assignment.
You're leaving the
building. Without hesitation.
Ready for orders, Commander.
Light Corvette here.
Our vehicles have been sabotaged.
I'm on. Standing by.
They won't hold
Watch
up much longer.
Watch out for those asteroids.
Iron cannon firing.
We might be small, but we pack a punch.
I might be small, but I pack a punch.
We've lost a squad member.
Waiting orders.
I may be small, but I pack a punch. I may be small, but I pack a punch. I may be slow, but I pack a punch. Everybody here just packs a punch. In case you weren't aware. I'd really like you to be over there somewhere. Being useful. Those things range. Good grief. Well, you taking the scenic route? What takes so long? You go shoot those things. Are you in range? I don't think so. No, not quite. You just hang back a bit. Do we not get healing? We don't get healing. Yeah, I don't think we get healing. How very useful. Odd that she's suddenly turning to engage the Secular. Oh, you got in way closer than I thought you were going to. That's not... That's... Go now. Right now. Just see a wave of turbo laser fire heading towards it. Where... You guys too. Oh, no, it's just being very weird about the range. Okay, well, whatever. Probably not worth it. Oh, hello. How much shields do you have? What about you? Wow. Oh, you know what? Capital? No, it's just... It seemed like she was taking not nearly as much damage as she has been. Yep, heavy frigate shipyard. Being weird with the collision or whatever it's called.
You've got the captain. Republic Light.
There's an actual name for the whatever that's called. I don't remember what it is.
Jan Dodonna, sir.
Those are the droids.
Destroyer ready.
Yeah, is this really necessary? Is this really necessary? I feel like it's really not. You can take this by yourself, I'm almost certain. Oh, that's a lot of high-grade missiles that are... Okay. I guess that's useful.
Eliminating target.
Adjusting course.
These clones how it's
light corvette hit.
We're ready.
Anyone need a repair?
Destroyer at station reinforcements.
All stations ready.
Watch out for those asteroids.
Again, it was outside of the ring, but this one isn't even... whatever.
At your discretion, your...
Attack formation.
We'll take them out.
Are you my chance of
launch?
Nope.
Yes, Commander.
Take out that fighter.
Dodonna reporting in.
Missile destroyer reporting in.
I might be small.
Sentinels picking up an enemy squadron approaching up ahead.
I suppose you could possibly send a few volleys that away.
Clearing the skies.
Okay. Well. So much for that full volley, I guess.
Sir, this is Bruce Squadron.
Dodonna reporting in.
Excellent shot. After the stragglers.
Yeah, now you got it.
This one's mine.
Ion cannon firing.
Locking on.
Interesting. The ion cannon seems to be favoring the acclimators over the victories. They're just victory ones. They're victory ones. Wonder if that's why. They do definitely have a lower priority for the victory ones over the victory twos. Odd how these seem to be, I don't know, somewhere comparable to these. We didn't actually lose shields on either of these? Really? Wow.
Emergency frequency open.
That's impressive. Is that all of the Gazantes? Oh, hello.
Ready to move out, sir. All stations ready.
Missile tubes loaded.
Ready to fire.
Got these things were here. I don't think there's much very significant though.
Ion cannon firing. Whatever it was they were looking for, it looks like they already found it.
Okay.
We have the upper hand.
Yeah, handful of Dredica and crab droids. Nothing major. But that was pretty good, that was. Yeah, I drastically overestimated, for some reason, how much stuff they had back here. Although, to be fair, fighting all of that together, like the subjugator and the battleship, that would have been nasty. I think this is our first time on this map, isn't it? No, it's not. Ayla was here early on. Wow, that was such a long time ago.
Get ready to move in!
Beginning construction.
But yeah, Ayla was actually on this planet. And... Because if you remember, early on, she and her fleet were on... some planet in like the mid-core-ish area, I think, somewhere like that, and the planet was not, at the time, the main CIS. It was, I want to say Trade Federation, something like that. And her forces were over the planet, sitting over the planet, when the Trade Federation, or whatever sub-faction of the CIS, integrated. And because of that, they got... and basically dumped off of the planet randomly onto one of our planets. And that planet that they got dumped to, for whatever reason, was Ryloth, right next door to here. And she and her forces were stuck back in this area for a long time. And they did end up actually taking this planet while they were back here. If anyone remembers that way back when. Ages and ages ago. Where are you going?
Stay together.
We're probably going to want something along these lines. That's not what you're actually supposed to be shooting at. Oh, that's irritating. What all do they have? That's an interesting place for that. Okay. That's a dangerous place for that, because there is no way that any anti-air is going to protect that. As we will soon find out. Oh. That probably would have been handy to know earlier. You're clear to go all the way up to here.
Hey. 1, 2, 3.
Confirm new stance.
Call it a shiny. Stay mobile. Ready when you are.
Stance.
You presume too much.
Confirm new stance.
Move in.
Bombing run available.
Was that? Well, that was. Don't see those very often. Okay, you lot are going that way. You... Oh, run, 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 run. Okay, no, no. Oh, there's a persuader there. I didn't even notice that. Oh no, there's two of them.
What is it?
Oh, you guys didn't actually take that. That was a mistake.
Reinforcements en route.
They're still not taking that. You have to be closer than that. You do realize. Oh, these things. You know, I do understand, like, things have a pursue, behavior when they get attacked, they like to pursue things. And I understand that. Like, over here. I told them to go here, and this thing saw something, engaged it, and whatever it was ran off, probably these crab droids, and it carried on pursuing them for however long. Now, Corey has said before that they don't want to remove, they can remove that capability, but they don't want to because they feel like it would be kind of, what's the word? It would be less useful, I guess, to the player to have their units just sit there being shot at without doing anything about it. So having that pursue behavior makes them sort of, basically what it is they kind of take care of themselves a little bit. Rather than you needing to necessarily micro them quite as much, because like, for example, we've got three different things going on here, and if these guys, like if these things, for example, were longer range than these guys, I don't think they are, but if they were, these guys would just slowly get picked apart without doing anything if they didn't have that pursue behavior. And again, I understand that. That makes sense. However, when you're talking about something like this, that is, first of all, heavy, slow, and kind of meant to be a centerpiece of your forces, I feel like it's something that really shouldn't be pursuing at all. Like, you tell it to go to a place, it should go to that place and stay there no matter what comes along shooting at it. Now, the AI, as far as I'm aware, the AI doesn't have any sort of problem with that because they don't use the pursuit behavior. They just give all of their forces orders. And because it's an AI, they can give them all orders instantaneously all across their forces and don't, like, microing their many forces isn't a big deal for them. It is kind of for the player, so I do understand that wanting things to be slightly self-sufficient. But again, at the same time, some things, I think, just should not do that. They should move to where you tell them to move, and then stop. And not want to pursue anything anywhere. Although, it's possible that because of the way that the game works, it's actually not possible to differentiate units. Like, Corey has said that they're capable of removing that functionality, but I'm not sure if that's a per unit thing or like a across the board on off switch type thing. You know, I don't, if it's all units across the board, then I can definitely see. But if it's on a per unit basis, then something like this should not pursue something like this. I don't know if the artillery pursues. I was going to say no, it can't be on a, it can't be all units across the board because artillery doesn't pursue, but actually I don't know if they do. They might.
Turret ready.
Well, this was my fault. I told them to attack those crab droids and they pulled them back. That was not the fault of the game. We can't actually really bombard anything, can we?
Bombardment canceled.
Maybe. I'm curious. I don't think I've ever seen if this works or not.
The enemy base shield's offline.
Well, that's a weakness. That probably needs to be addressed. If you ask me, that's, yeah, that's kind of overpowered. Well, not really overpowered, but it's certainly that can't be intended. Like, it's under the shield bubble for a reason, right? Okay, well, you're up. Head in. Blow up everything.
Reinforcement point contested.
Why am I having you do that?
Bombers at the ready.
Gold squad. Oh, I didn't mean that. Dang it. I was trying to. Okay, well, it might still get that. What landing zone? Oh, I kind of don't care. I might care a little bit.
Yes.
You're violating orders. Stay together.
They're just everywhere, man. And you're just being completely ineffectual here. You're doing just fine. Uh-oh. Oh no, they got the Lardy. Okay, I underestimated how much there was right there. Head on over here. Where did you? Well, it was better than nothing, I suppose. Certainly could have accidentally just completely missed everything, which would have been very irritating. You just stay there. These guys are just kind of rolling through, wrecking everything. So is this, to be honest. I thought they were going to add icons above the infantry to make it easier to tell that there's actually infantry. Because those B1s are so hard to see.
Prepare to die.
Guys. Hello? Of course, and then there's that, whatever that is, where they just don't shoot what you tell them to shoot. Like, certainly for things like Jedi, or any kind of melee unit, definitely they need to have the pursue functionality, because if they didn't, you would just be playing the entire time, the entire game, on the ground, microwing them if you wanted to use them. Otherwise, they would just get chewed up by anything. Alrighty. Well, that's definitely going to do it for this episode. It's getting to be rather long. Longer than I expected. Longer than I meant to. Longer than I meant to go. But we've, completely secured this area. Completely secured this area. Gotten forces through here, destroyed a fair number of their forces, and I think we're well on our way to being finished with our main goals. To be honest, at this point, I'm going to move this force. To here. We're going to shut down their movement through here. I don't know if you noticed, but we probed that planet during this episode and they still had 11 battleships. But they do have 3 over here. So I'm feeling like they must have. Well, I guess not necessarily must have. We don't know how much they have back here. But it seems likely that they pulled stuff off of Pamont. But at the same time, I don't actually remember the number that was there last time we probed it, because it was just huge and absurd and ridiculous and not something we could deal with. So I don't remember what the actual number was, but, you know. I will say, though, I want to add Mimbon to our list of planets that we definitely want to take, because it's kind of just here in the middle of our space, you know. Like, this seems like a fairly important planet to want to also take. I know it's technically not in the core. I mean, I don't think these two are either, but I'm counting it as part of the core. But it's core word enough, I would say. Like, all of this mess out here, I'm willing to say, well, it's just the remnants of the CIS, the last holdouts, and the Empire is going to go through there and conquer it. But this one in particular seems like something that we should do, and it's not a big deal. Other than that, though, yeah. The last things to do for our main goals are lock in Pomont, take on Trench, and I do think we're going to do Sullust too. Ooh, we should take this too. There's no reason not to. That's a half-decent fleet. I suppose if the HV gun doesn't shoot it down in the next, you know, few weeks or so, we should probably actually deal with that. Like, just for thematic purposes, I think a random stray CIS Lucrehulk battleship sitting over Corellia is probably not good PR for the Empire, if nothing else. But yes, that's the plan for the next several episodes, however long it is. And that is also the end of this episode. So, hope you've enjoyed it so far. I know the episodes are getting quite long, but we're almost done here, to be honest. So, it's probably to be expected, right? Anyway, thank you for watching. Take care, and farewell. You think we'll catch any ships going across Jibim, or do you think they've finished moving stuff? It's hard to say.